I'm going to demonstrate my infrared automatic switching that has been developed by my father and myself. This switch is currently pointing in the wrong direction. You'll see that the engine's going to come through, hit the sensor, and the switch sets the right way. We'll put him back. There's three switches, the one you just saw, this curved switch, and this switch and the reverse switch, which have the installations completed on them. The circuitry is hanging out down here right now. You can see we got some latching relays, capacitors, transistors, resistors, and the chips here. These chipsets are what are doing the thinking for the circuit, and then some power supply regulator stuff to make sure the voltage stays stable. And then we have all the wires coming in, and they all run out to the switches and to the switch machine controllers. Okay, so you got a good look at that, I'm guessing. Yeah. As you can see here, this switch is set in the wrong direction. Signal is red, and the train is approaching into it. The train will blow by the signal, and then the switch will automatically switch for it, so I don't have a short and can continue my operations. Once the Minuetto here gets started up, we'll get on our way. Here we go. There it goes. It switched and the signal through. Get him going, and this first switch is already set the wrong way. When the train comes through and hits that black sensor, it throws. All right, excellent. All right, here we come in the reverse loop. There it was, automatic switching. Sensors are infrared. See, when I get over here, you start seeing the little blue lights. That's the infrared signal coming up. Can't quite get the other one to shine for you real good. There you go. There you can see it. Infrared light, you can't see them. And those little black boxes are the pickups. They're right next to each other. And we got them wrapped in, it's really hard to see there. They're wrapped in heat shrink tubing and then a little square's cut out on top to shield them from the side so they don't fail. These are done a little differently. I wrapped the heat shrink tubing around the LED itself and had to stick it up and space them out a little further. Both are pretty reliable. I found that the one that's tighter, the other version, actually is more reliable with more engines. So I'm going to stick with this setup from now on. Here we go, the switch is set the wrong way. And pow. Again. As you can see, it has a pretty effective rate of fire. This train's moving pretty quick. Pretty cool. And there it is, automatic switching on DCC layout.